Students, now let us consider a single direction conveyor model. This is an important model for material handling equipment, which is actually used for loading and unloading stations separated by a distance of dm. So there would be a loading station and unloading station, and the distance between them would be represented by d in terms of meters. Ignoring accelerations and deceleration effects, the conveyor operates at a speed of V meters per minute. So V would actually represent the speed of that conveyor. It's a single direction conveyor model. So that means it would move in one direction from loading to unloading. Containers are loaded at the one end and unloaded at the other. The travel time to transport containers from the load station to the unload station is d by v minutes. So d over v ratio will actually give you the total travel time. Let the loading time be l and the spacing between the container be s. So these are the abbreviations which we'll use in the model. It's a simple model where S over L, where S would actually represent the spacing between the two stations. So S over V should be greater than or equal to L, and V over S, the ratio of the speed of the conveyor over the spacing, should be less than or equal to the inverse of that L. The time required to unload the, that means the loading time L, the time required to unload the conveyor must be less than or equal to the loading time. So that means your loading and unloading times should be comparable with each other. So if the container can hold n parts, then the part flow rate R on the conveyor system will be given as, so this would be the part flow rate on the conveyor, single conveyor direction conveyor. It will be given by R is equal to N V over S, where N would actually represents number of parts, and it should be less than or equal to, it is bounded by the ratio of N over L. This model assumes that there are no empty trips. What does it mean? That your traffic factor would actually be equal to 1, and the conveyor does not stop for loading or unloading. So what does it mean? There are no empty trips. Conveyor khali nahi chalega. This is the assumption for this model. And it would be given by R. The flow rate is the important thing, which is actually given by N V over S. And it should not be higher than, or it should be equal to, the ratio of N over L. It is bounded. It is bounded from above by the ratio of N over L. So students, in a single direction conveyor model, we have seen about the flow rate and the assumption of that model. And it's actually a basic model for the conveyor system. Thank you.